Hi, here I will show you how to flash the BK7231T single color Tuya LED strip in order to free it from the cloud and pair with Home Assistant. Furthermore, I will also show here two very easy modifications for such strip. First, I will add an extra IR receiver so LEDs can be also controlled via TV remote. And then I will add some extra buttons that can also be used to control the brightness and state of LEDs. Let's start with opening the controller case. It's very easy to do with a flat screwdriver. As you can see, there is WB3S Wi-Fi module inside. It's using BK7231T chip. WB3S is very easy to flash. It requires only a USB to UART converter. In this particular case, you just only need to solder RX, TX and ground. You can use any DC adapter for powering the strip during flashing. Let's start by adding some flex on the pads. It will make soldering easier. Then add some extra PB solder to the pads. Also remember to thin the wires. Finally, hold the wire with your one hand and solder it to the pad with other hand. Do not move wire first. Let the solder solidify. Wires are soldered. Now you can connect them to USB to UART converter. Here is entire flashing setup. It's very simple. Now you just need to use bkWriter 1.60 to flash the BK7231. Download link is in the video description. Select the correct firmware file and start flashing in bkWriter 1.60. Then disconnect and reconnect the power to the strip. This is needed for flashing to proceed, because bkWriter 1.60 is waiting for BK7231 reboot. Flashing will proceed once reboot is done. Now you can connect to OpenBKey access point and configure to I/O roles, MQTT and much more. But this time we will show more than just flashing. Let's modify our LED strip. OpenBeacon allows us to add more features to any IoT device. Let's find some IR receiver that we can use with our strip. IR receivers can be found in old DVD players, TVs, VCRs, and many other devices. Desolder the IR receiver, but remember to check its connection first. You will need to know which pin is ground, which is power, and which is signal output. Solder extra wires to Wi-Fi module. You will need power, ground, and some unused I/O signal for IR input. Connect the IR receiver. Remember that some IR receivers might require 5 volts to work. Other ones will work on 3.3 volts. Okay, now we can also add some extra buttons to the strip. Procedure will be very similar. Just solder extra wires and connect a protoboard with buttons. You can see the schematic on the screen. In OpenBeacon web panel, select the receiver role for the chosen I/O. Reboot OBK device. Now, in the OBK web app logs, you should be able to see the IR events while pressing buttons on your IR remote. You can publish those events to Home Assistant by MQTT or script them on OBK. For example, pressing remote button can change LED strip brightness or color. In order to script remote events, go to LittleFS, create a file called odoexec.bat and write your script there. You can also write event handlers for buttons in LittleFS. Multiple buttons events are supported, like on-click, on-double-click, on-hold. See our documentation for full list of events. Here is the final version of our script. As you can see, device can be powered on and off by a button. Second button can control its brightness and third can power it off after a certain amount of time. TV remote also works. It can control brightness and power state of the LEDs. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please visit our forums. You can also visit online device database full of flashing guides, I/O templates and useful hints. Remember that you can also submit your own device to help grow our database. See ya!